for his prominence in the industry right now. The four-point roll left to right. Bourbon and the Yak 110. Forming perfectly, but in between them, a 3,000-pound plus jet engine. Airplane weighs in at almost 5,000 pounds, but welding two Yak 55s together was one of the most unusual accomplishments in aviation. Circle like that without even banking the airplane over. It's amazing what he can accomplish. The one-of-a-kind design by joining two Yak 55 fuselages. Airplane first appeared at the Mountain Home Air Force Base in Idaho in June of 2018. The energy going, cross control, pirouette around the left wing tip. Whoa, finishing out inverted. Jeff Bourbon coming back for a hover maneuver. As soon as he gets the pick of the first, here's one more chance. All that power from the jet engine, 3,000 pounds of thrust, 360 horsepower per engine, hangs it on the prop. Whoa! It can sit there all day. Backing it up. Can you possibly believe that Orville and Wilbur Wright could have envisioned a maneuver like that with an airplane? Jeff Bourbon and the Yak 110.
Totally rebuilt and replicated in the jungle camouflage paint scheme of the United States Air Force 8th Special Operations Squadron, 14th Special Operations Wing, stationed at Chien Hoa Air Base, Vietnam, in 1970. The external hardpoints were retained, as was the weapons firing system, which I now use to power and fire in the force. If you remember with my original Wild Thing 150, this flight is no less dangerous as the IAR does not have inverted.
By creating a smoke screen for hate to come through. We can feel the shockwave from here. All right, so a standing snap. We've got Michael Wiskus and Hayden Prophet. Here we go. Power is on. Michael is firewall with the pitch. Michael Wiskus is the first one off the ground. Of course, in this race, he's the only one off the ground.
That's a guy.
against the 12,000-pound thrust jet truck.
McMinnville, what do you think so far of Sean D. Tucker? Okay, folks, this is that moment that Sean is now ready to attempt to slice all three ribbons. But first, as a mark of precision, he'll try to duck underneath that first ribbon without slicing it. He's going to do that in just a few moments once he makes sure he's in tune with the wind and density altitude at that very low altitude. Now returning back to the sky for the alley-oop loop. Tumbling out of that maneuver and now locking in his sights ribbon number three. He'll attempt to go underneath it without slicing. Pulls it off and returns to the sky. He's now ready to attempt to slice all three ribbons in one single pass at three separate flight attitudes. Ready or not, McMinnville, here we go. Sean lowers his altitude, 220 miles an hour. It's a right knife edge through ribbon one, left knife edge through ribbon two, and then taking out that third and final ribbon. He is pushing his limits, pushing his flying machine. He's living with passion. Let's make some noise for Sean D. Tucker.
Upside down at 2,500 feet, the distinctive Apollo landing craft shape, the red jet standing out against the white clouds. On the right of Red 1 in Apollo is Red 2, Flight Lieutenant Damo Green. Damo has previously flown the Hawk as an aggressor pilot. He then flew the Typhoon on the front line and is in his first year on.
Now, holding the front.
On the right of Red 2 in Concord is another new pilot for 2019. That's Red 4, Flight Lieutenant Gregor Oxton. Red 1 now calling the aircraft into one of our most technically difficult formations to fly, with six aircraft all flying in line abreast, and Red 6 and 7 tucking in behind. It's Phoenix. On the left of Red 1 in Phoenix is Red 3, Squadron Leader Mike. Red 1 rolling Phoenix out to our right-hand side, the coloured smoke about to come off before the aircraft represents another shape from history. Upside down at 2,500 feet, the Lancaster roll. Now, many of you may not think the Lancaster was an aerobatic aircraft, but the well-known British test pilot aboard calls Red 9 as Reds 8 and 9 put the coloured smoke on, rolling around the rest of the formation. Red 1 about to bank the aircraft to the left, changing smoke colour as they go in tornado. Enid, break, break, go, calls Red 1. Keep your eye on the back four. There is the intersection, that's six.
Now,
6 and 7 staying low with the 4-point roll. That's 8 and 9 rolling on. Red 9 is about to fly straight down the middle in the goose. Pulling up to the vertical, Red 9 is Flight Lieutenant Dan Lowes. Dan is a former Typhoon pilot and weapons instructor. He's on his third and final year with the team. Red 1 leads Enid section off to our left. The coloured smoke about to come on as they break in the vortex. To call them into a right-hand turn. Red 5 kicking his aircraft out with the rudder pedals. The aircraft moving like a pendulum as they enter the turn. Now, normally in the red arrows, the even numbers fly on the right, the odd numbers fly on the left. Red 1 is about to push them into a reverse battle formation. This time we've got the even numbers on the left and the odd numbers on the right. In order to get back onto the right side of the formation, we're going to perform a maneuver called the slalom. There it is, the aircraft slalom to the correct side, and the coloured smoke about to come on as they're back in battle formation. Now, as with any display, the Royal Air Force aerobatic team is a real team effort. We have 11 pilots wearing the red suits, but over 120 blue suits, our support team who cover everything from maintenance through to administration, logistics, photographers, and everything in between. And a part of that team is the dye team that put the red and blue dye in the smoke for passes like this. Smoke in the corkscrew. It sings spectacular Jippo Break.